is everything. Pretty soon she'll figure out what his intentions were about. And that's what you get for falling again. You can never get him out of your head. And that's what you get for falling again. You can never get him out of your head. It's the way that he makes you feel. It's the way that he kisses you. It's the way that he makes you fall. As usual, with bruises on her ego and
killer. Good morning, Cougars. Welcome back. Cougar TV is next. Stay tuned.
Today we'll see the SGA report and we'll meet with QO security team leader Mr. Mike Owens, who has some important information and advice for us. We'll join the sports report and get some commentary on the Super Bowl, and we'll see three of QO's star athletes honored for their accomplishments in a big way. But first, the Pledge of the Flag. Please stand. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today is February 4th, 2005, and the SAT word of the day is tedious. It's an adjective meaning dull or boring. As in, as time passed and the history professor continued to drone on and on, the lecture became increasingly tedious. You heard right, Cougars. Yearbook orders are being taken in room 241 at the low, low cost of only $65. But I bet if you wait long enough, you'll be able to get them at $70 or even $75. Order yours today. And speaking of the yearbook, if you play and compete in an extreme or alternative sport outside of school, get in touch with Miss Klein, Morgan Wilson, or Greg Gidley for a chance to be featured in a spread. Fame could be just a call away. The SGA report is next.
Hey Cougars, this is Lindsay Abbott, your third VP.
And this is Avnish Mara, your Secretary of Technology.
Cougars, be sure to keep a heads up for the QO's upcoming basketball tournament.
Have you ever wanted to wear a hat at school?
Or donate money to the tsunami relief?
Well, then you can do both of those things on Tuesday, February 15th. If you wear your hat to school, you just have to pay $1, or if you're feeling generous, you can give a little more to support the tsunami relief. And you can wear your hat for the entire day.
Congratulations to Adam Danoff for choosing to run for student member of the board. Sign up now outside the SGA office to be a member of the nomination committee to represent both Adam and QO.
Lindsay, I have a question for you. Do you have a Valentine?
I have someone in mind.
Uh-huh. Well, the senior class will be selling roses and carnations starting next on Monday, this coming Monday. In the Red Hall during lunch.
That's right. And Mr. and Ms. QO will be held on February 17th at 7 p.m. It's going to be amazing, so everyone be out there to support your friends.
And now the moment that you've all been waiting for. The results from the morning announcements tryouts are in, and your two juniors who will be doing the morning announcements are, drumroll please, Jill Turgenati and Summit Agarwal.
Seniors, no worries. Your graduation speaker will be announced shortly. And if you have any questions as to who it is, see Tom Kuhn. The graduation committee and seniors officers, just a reminder, there is a meeting today after school with Mr. Shea.
And one last announcement.
Anyone who didn't order a This Is Our House t-shirt but would still like to buy one, there are a limited number available in room 128. They're on a first-come, first-served basis. So bring $17 in cash or check made out to QOHS and pick one up today and support the sophomore class. That's
well,
all we have
for
today.
Thank you and bye-bye.
Here's a final warning from the PTSA. you can still take a practice SAT and see how you do. Just show up at 8:30 a.m. tomorrow morning with a check for $15 made out to the PTSA. You'll even receive advice on how to improve your score.
Okay, seniors, the gloves are off now. It has begun. The yearly harangue about caps and gowns and their currently low price of only $70 is underway. And yes, in March, the price will begin the upward trend. Order yours now and save yourself some cash. And save us from having to hear this announcement every day until our ears bleed.
Not to be tedious, and on a very related note, the senior class officers are ordering all of the aforementioned caps and gowns next Friday, February 11th. That means that all seniors need to turn in sizing forms now. Even if you have not purchased your cap and gown yet, the forms are available on the senior wall and in room 241. You need to include your name, school, sex, height, and weight. The completed form should be turned in to Ms. Klein in room 241.
Any senior who wants their mid-year report sent out will need one envelope for each school you want to send your senior first semester grades to. Address your envelopes to your school and put one first-class stamp on your envelope. Please get your envelopes to the registrar as soon as possible.
Up next, we meet that new star of stage, screen, and QO security, Mr. Mike Owens, head of the world-renowned QO security team, with some timely information for us to heed.
Hi, I'm Mike Owens, security team leader, Quince Orchard High School. What we're going to do today is we're going to walk around Quince Orchard High School. This is after school, after the buses have gone, and we're going to look at some of the things that the students have, be it left around, forgotten, or misplaced in the hallway. We're doing this for safety reasons and to take care of your possessions, the student possessions. You ready, Tom? Let's go. So, all right, it's Mike Owens again, Quince Orchard High School. Looking behind me, I have a group of students where I've got backpacks and their possessions next to them. Right now, it's fine, but what happens if? What happens if they go to the bathroom? What happens if they go make a phone call? That's when their possessions are left behind. When their possessions are left behind, that's where we have the issues. Tom, you want to come with me? What we're looking for here is these students in the hall are out here for an after-school sports activity, but my question to the staff is, and to the students, where are their materials? Where are their backpacks? Are they secured? Are they in lockers? Are they in a classroom? Or are they just sitting out somewhere for somebody to find? All right, this is lunchtime, and one of the things we see at lunchtime is we have a backpack here unattended. So when we're looking at security-related things here at Quince Orchard, we have a backpack that's unattended, so it's fair game if somebody wants to look in it and take any of the possessions out of it. What you're looking at now is students in the hallway during lunch. Every student's doing the right thing, not a big deal. But what happens if a student gets up, go to the bathroom, they get up and talk to their friend, they leave their backpack, purse, or possessions unattended? Again, it's a problem. What I'd like to see, and what Quince Orchard would like to see, is something simple as know where your possessions are and keep them attended.
Attention all QO students and staff. Do you really need that extra bag of chips or soda? The Red Cross Club points out that there is still a great need for donations for the Tsunami Relief Fund. Please stop by the main office anytime during the school day and donate any spare change to this important cause. The National Honor Society will meet today during lunch in the auditorium.
The Prowler is now selling Valentine's Day messages that will be featured in the February issue. If you're interested, talk to a member of the paper, or come to the table at the Red Hall, or go right to room 132 for more information.
Attention all you creative cougars. Today is the last call for submitting your poems, artwork, and short stories to the literary magazine. Hurry up and get your work to the folders in your English classroom or to Ms. Harding.
The Rec Club is having a second Seven Springs Weekend ski or snowboard trip in March. This trip is limited to 18 students, and as of now, there are only 12 spaces left. Forms can be picked up from Mr. Prather, Mr. Redding, or from the Rec Board in the Red Hall.
The SAD Club wants to remind you all of the Battle of the Bands competition hosted by the Montgomery County SAD Club. Come to room 228F to pick up a registration form, but hurry, the forms are due by today.
Up next is a sport report with Lynn Yendo and Katie Purdy.
Hey, Cougars, it's Lynn and Katie again.
That's right, we're back.
And we're very excited.
Let's start off with a very coordinated Palm squad.
They competed last Saturday in the Northwest Palm Competition.
The squad took home the spirit stick yet again.
Congratulations. Moving on to our wrestling team, who competed against Churchill on Tuesday.
The Cougars absolutely crushed the Bulldogs.
Naturally.
Great job to Eddie Vaughn and Hector Luna for leading the team.
They will wrestle BCC and Magruder tomorrow at 1 at Magruder.
Swimming is also competing tomorrow.
They'll be at the Olney Swim Center against Churchill at 9:15.
Last week, the guys' team lost a close meet to Wooten, making them 3-1.
The girls crushed Wooten, continuing their undefeated season at 4-0.
Now on to our speedy indoor track team.
And we're competing nowhere until regionals on February 14th.
That's Valentine's Day, so make sure to show the indoor track team some love. Well, what's next, Lynn?
Basketball, of course.
Oh yeah, I play that sport.
And I'm not coordinated enough to.
Well, the girls' team played Churchill on Monday and lost a close game 50-56.
Vicki Lyle and Kelly Phillips both had great games.
Last night, we lost to Walter Johnson, but Aaron Broderick played very well.
The girls' JV team absolutely crushed Walter Johnson, winning 40-27.
The boys' JV team is spectacular, beating both Churchill and Walter Johnson this week.
The varsity guys crushed Gaithersburg on Friday and then lost an extremely close double overtime game to Churchill on Monday.
Thursday against WJ, the guys won 61-47, led by Jermaine, who had 27 points.
Holy moly, that's a lot. Well, that's all the winter sports we have to cover, but we aren't done yet.
We didn't think we would be talking about football in February, but we can't forget the Super Bowl.
And we really wanted to find out what you guys had to say about Sunday's big game. So roll the clip.
And the Super Bowl this weekend is the Patriots and the Eagles.
I'm here with football expert extraordinaire Greg Kamara. And what are your predictions for the Super Bowl?
The Patriots are definitely going to win. Philly is terrible, and it's the worst city in the United States.
Let's get serious. I have no idea at all.
I'm here with the Student Academy of Science, and they predict that for the Super Bowl, who's going to win?
Go Pats!
I'm here with student genius Arden Mascotti. Arden, who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl?
Who's in it?
Well, I think the Eagles are going to win because they're from New York.
I'm with Nash Kuhn. Nash, who do you think is going to win the Super Bowl?
Well, if we examine the categorical imperative, which articulates itself in a football game of this nature, we would see that the Patriots have absolutely no possibility of losing because the Patriots have the best team.
Eagles!
I really think that the Eagles are going to win the Super Bowl because I like to root for the underdogs. Patriots have won way too many times, so go Eagles.
I'm here with Brian. Who do you think is a better quarterback, Donovan McNabb or Tom Brady?
I'm going to have to go with Tom Brady because he's got an unbelievable playoff record, and he's led his team to the Super Bowl twice, so he's going to bring it home.
Like Mississippi?
Yeah, they're from Mississippi, and Mississippi rocks all day.
Wow. I just wish that my man, Michael Vick, was in the Super Bowl.
That's all right, Katie. There's always next year. But you know who we may see in the Super Bowl one day?
Who? Maybe some QO players.
Yes, like Scott Rydell, Cameron George, or Brendan Willard.
Well, they are definitely on their way. These three QO football stars signed to play college football this week.
Check out what happened Wednesday on National Signing Day.
Okay. I gotta get a couple.
So we
Brandon.
I have no idea.
There you go.
I look confused.
Nice freaking job, bro. Smile, okay? I want to say in front of everybody that this is a great day for Clint Orchard High School and these three guys and their families. We're glad you guys all could be in their friends. You know, we wanted their friends and people that have supported these guys for the last 4 years. It's important that you guys are here too, so we want to thank you for that. And if you guys want to go ahead and, on behalf of Coach Neesmith and myself, the coaching staff, we're honored to have you guys, you know, sign this piece of paper here and all your hard work and commitment. So, congratulations.
Hello.
There's a couple of them. Let's just sign a big one, and we've got to get them in the fax machine.
Put the cameras here. Okay. Anybody? I don't want flash.
Never seen
come on.
Aww.
All right. Hi.
Wow, those guys sure are great athletes.
Yeah, and that action-packed clip makes me miss football season with all the fans and school spirit.
Well, everyone should bring that football spirit out tonight when our basketball teams take on Whitman.
The girls play at 5:15 and the boys at 7, so come cheer them on. And this just in, congratulations to Brendan Lynch. Over the weekend, he won the Middle Atlantic States Tennis Championship in the 18 and under division. He did not lose
a single set in the whole tournament.
Wow. Well, that's all the sports news for this week, Cougars.
Make sure to show the teams your support.
Bye.
Bye.
That wraps up our show, Cougars.
For those of you who missed the calendar, stay tuned. It will roll again after the credits.
Have a safe and wonderful weekend.